drew last on weekend is a game we could have won. We missed chances, especially in the first half. Can you comment on that?
Yeah, that's true. It's a game that we were supposed to have won. Why? Because, like you were saying, we dominated the match, and I believe we were supposed to have got maximum points out of the game. But unfortunately, luck was also not on our side. Created goal scoring opportunities, but we are not clinical. But at the same time, a draw to us, to the boys, I think it's something that we can also accommodate going forward.
And one other issue might be, we saw in the opening minutes we nearly conceded the goal. The ball was cleared on the line. Can you say it's something that maybe we didn't switch onto the game on time?
Yeah. Not really that we did not switch on, because I think from the first minute we did show our opponents that we really wanted to win the match. I think our goalkeeper on the day did not really have a very good day in the office. Why am I saying that? It's some of decisions were not usual, like the one that we, you know, him as so long knowing him. You know, at times one never has a good day in the office. I think it was one of those games, one of those days, whereby I think he was putting himself under a lot of pressure, because we are not just playing a team that is, I won't say LMPS is struggling. LMPS has been playing well for the past three games. So it was not a game whereby one would say it was going to be a walk in the park for us, you know, especially with those high balls. Because if you recall, decisions whereby he was somehow lost was when they were playing those high balls of theirs, which is the area where they are very good at. But I think we are able to deal with those. The defense came into being, they covered him well. Unfortunately, it's only the last minute in the referee's optional time whereby we conceded the goal.
And one would say we missed chances, especially in our previous two games against Dinare. We missed a chance. Well, I'm not going to expose him, but we know we missed a chance when playing against Dinare. We missed some chances last week. Isn't it a worry to you that maybe those missed chances will come back to haunt us later?
Not really. The good thing as a team is when you have your team playing, creating goal scoring opportunities, you know, it's good that you can see your players are creating those goal scoring opportunities. The only thing now is just to work with them, not too much pressure on them, but they should realize that it's very good to score as many goals as you can. Other than when you play, you find you don't even go into the attacking third. You know, you don't create goal scoring opportunities. So for me, with my players, I think I would say I'm satisfied with the commitment that they've shown. They just need that luck. They just need that calmness in front of the goal now. I think there'll be a time that comes when we'll be scoring goals.
coach, three of your players were not available for selection this weekend. Do you think them not being around affected your plans for the game?
Not really. Why am I saying that is the other guys who were left, they are still members of this family, of the team. And I believe, we believe in them, that when the others are not around, the ones who are left behind can always do the work. And I was happy with the way our team played. I was happy with the way they conducted themselves under a lot of pressure, because it was not an easy game for us, you know, with the type of game that LMPS plays. I think they played according to our gameplay. They stuck to it and they showed the hunger, you know. So all we need to do as the technical team, the management, is just to support them, you know, psychologically, because now it's something that we need also to work on.
And one would say we saw Lesia being recalled from the camp to the team. He didn't link the team to Botswana, or is it Swaziland? I don't know. Can we say, is it because we don't have a replacement for him on that position?
Yeah, he has an edge on the other guys that we have here. And also, he did not play last match against Dinari. So we wanted him to be part of this team, because we are still building a team. We're still building, you know, he's part of the team that comes from the developmental team. So it's a work in progress. So he's part of that work in progress.
From my opinion, coach, I saw the boys getting fatigued in the dying minutes of the game, and they end up conceding a goal. But in the last games, they didn't get fatigued. What do you think was the problem this weekend compared to the last games?
It was a very physical game. This is one of the games, I think, that we've played whereby our opposition was very, very physical. So it trained them out. You know, that's why I'm saying I was satisfied with the way they conducted themselves, because they were able to absorb what the opponents were giving. You know, not only the you know, the playing side of things, but it was quite hectic for them. And I think we are on the right track. You know, the fatigue levels, I think it's something that we shouldn't really worry ourselves much about. We will be able to deal with that as time goes on.
And Nadi Morapeli, you scored a beautiful goal, an important goal for the team. But what did you learn from the game?
From the game, what I've learned is the game was tough. The game needed patience, and the game needed a little bit of communication. Because what you can see is lately, most of the teams that play on the Premier League of Lesotho, when they don't have communication, it's the first thing that we need to see that we have it. Because without communication, you will never win the game. Apart from that, being united as a team, it's something that can take the team too far, or maybe on top 8 or top 4. So all in all, I can say what I've learned is the game was tough, and it needed a person who works hard, very hard for his team and for his teammates also.
And how important was it for you guys to win it?
Well, it was very important, because when we will be having those points, they'll be taking us to the top 4. So as you know that every team has its own objective, maybe of the season. So I think it is something that we needed mostly, because we still want to be there on top 4.
Hey coach, We saw Gabelo Salomon after being registered, being in the 18-man squad. Are we about to see him play soon? Even the goalkeeper, Tangiso Imakanyo, are we about to see them play very soon?
Yes, I think we'll see them. They've been doing very well in training. They've shown a lot of commitment and character. So I think they deserve to be in the lineup for our previous match. And because, you know, people at times tend to think that if somebody is on the bench and he does not have that game time, he's not playing. To be on that bench, it mentally, it wakes you up. So I think they have learned a lot from being on the bench, so that in the forthcoming matches they'll be ready for any match that can come.
Okay, coach. What can you say? You have lost so many games, about four or five. You have lost so many games, about four or five. What can you say to the fans out there? And what are you promising to them about the next games?
For having lost matches, I think, I don't know about the fourth one. Yes, probably I would say yes. Now I'm part of Kick4Life. I've only lost two since I came in, and the other ones, yes, I'll carry them, the losses, because I'm part of the team now. But losing is part of the game. It's either you win, you draw, or you lose. So it's what you take out of the loss. What is it? Good attributes that you can take from the loss that would make you a better team for the next matches. I think, like I've just said earlier, I believe to the fans, they've given us a very good support. One thing for sure, we are on the right track with our progress going forward. You know, we have youngsters, we are only 2 years in the league. So all the projections that we have had, they are on track.
Yeah. Thanks. Morapeli, you are among the top scorers in the Premier League, and you haven't yet received a national team call-up. Not the under-20, I'm talking about the Queen. Does that affect you as a player?
No, it doesn't. The reason why I say it doesn't, it's because I can say I have my own objectives. We have been the top goal scorer. And one of my objectives that I can share with you is I'm willing to help my team as possible as I can, as far as I can. That's one of my objectives. So being not part of the national team, it's something that doesn't affect my performance or anything amongst me. It doesn't at all.
Looking at the position you play, you are playing as a midfielder, wide midfielder. But you have been scoring goals. What have you been doing to be the top scorer of the team or to get more goals more than our strikers?
What I normally do is communicate more before the game starts with my teammates, all of them. After that, what I do is to make sure that every single ball I have to give it or to share it to them as strikers. So the positioning that I'll be having, or the way I create scoring, is the one that allows me most of the time to be on site. That's why I normally get my goals.
Okay, and still on the position and the goals that you've been scoring, my first question would be, where do you like or where do you enjoy playing most? On the right wing or on the left wing? And the other question would be, looks like you're enjoying yourself in front of the goals, getting more goals. Can you tell us what the secret behind those goals?
The first position I like is being the central attacking midfield. But as a player, you have to be someone who knows that wherever my coach wants me to feed, I can feed. That's what I can say. And about my goals, yeah, like I said, I have my own objectives with my goals. So those objectives, I don't like to share them because because they are one of those things that I want to say, okay, the moment it's there, it's the time that I'll say, okay, I can share it with you as people that what I wanted is this.
But right now you have almost 6 goals in the Premier League. Are we yet to see more goals, and how many goals can you promise the fans out there by the end of the season?
Actually, I'll just say, I just want to score as much as I can, because what I want is, or what I'm saying in my mind is, the top goal scorer of the league, he's now having about 11 and I'm 6, that is minus 5, I'm missing. So, I don't think 5 is too much for me to handle it. I'm still there, I'm still counting myself on the top 5, even if I have 6, he gets 11. I'm still there, I'm gonna be there. And for the fans, I'm promising them I'm gonna fight more and more to be the one of the top goal scorer in this season.
And most of the time you talk about being on the top 4, and we know by the start of the season, the mandate was that maybe the team finishes at least on the top 8. But it looks like there's a chance that you might finish on the top 4. Is it something that you guys are looking up for?
Yes, I can say yes. Because when you say you want to be on top 8, that means it's like you're telling yourself that it's either top 8 or I'm out of top 8. So what I can say is, me and my colleagues, we're just saying, okay, we want to be on top 4 because top 8, we take it as minus. Like something that will come up when we say, okay, we haven't been on top 4. So top 8, it's something that, it's our second choice, in other words, it's our second choice. Because I don't want us to aim for top 8, yet we know that top 4 is the one that we can aim for.
I think, Chris, Kick4Life FC has been in the Premier League for 2 seasons. But looking at their players, they now have like 5 players in the national teams. How does it make you feel as the team director of football?
Yeah, very proud to have so many players getting national team call-ups. Obviously we've got 2 in the senior team now, 3 went with the under-20s, but we've actually got 4 in the under-20s in total, including Lesoetsa. And yeah, obviously it's great for us as a brand, as Kick4Life. It shows, you know, it's what we're all about. It's about wanting people to get opportunities through Kick4Life, and I believe by the environment they've been brought up in through the development team and through the first team, through the coaching that they get, through the support they get, and through the organisation, it's enabled them to be able to go and get that national team call ups and the experience they're getting there. So obviously it shows that we're doing our job, both on and off the pitch as Kick4Life. And we're very proud that they're representing us for the national teams.
So another question. I'm not sure. Are we having any changes in the technical team? We didn't see the goalkeeper coach this weekend.
No, he was with the under-20s. He's part of the coaching setup there, so he was away with those guys. Yeah, no, we're not. Robert's, we spoke about this coach, Robert's done a fantastic job as goalkeeper coach. And we actually had to persuade him to stay when he had an offer from another team recently. So, yeah, we really want to keep on with Robert. So, no, unless coach tells me he wants to make any changes, there's no plan changes at the moment at all.
But that doesn't affect your team, I mean, on the goalkeeping department when is away?
I mean, yes it does, because obviously Robert's done a great job with Sele. We were talking just yesterday that I think I think Sele obviously probably gives him more confidence when Robert's there, and Robert gives him great support. So obviously it's not ideal for him not to be there, but at the same time I think we have a duty to support the national teams as well as ourselves, and if us allowing some of our players and some of our coaches to travel to help the national teams, then we're fine to do that. We'll accommodate that as much as we can. Like Coach said, the only one that we didn't was Lesoetsa because we couldn't afford to let both of our left backs leave, so we negotiated something there. So yeah, in an ideal world Robert would have been with us, but you know, we'll try to never stand in anyone's way when it comes to national team duties.
Okay. And one other person that we missed on the bench was our physio.
Yeah, you'll have to ask him where he was, I'm not sure. I think he was having a day off, he had a hard week last week.
But is that not affecting the team?
I mean, I think we're still looking to bring in a full-time physio anyway, you'll see. We made a change recently and our previous physio is no longer with us. So at the moment Gambino, actually, to be fair, is standing in and doing a good job, just filling in until we find somebody. So again, not ideal not to have physio there every week and a full-time physio, but it's something we're looking at and we're working on.
Okay. And Coach, going forward, our next game is against LGF. You know, they play physical football. Our boys, you know, they're still the youngsters. Are you not worried? And the other factor may be, we're going to take at least 2 weeks for play. Is it not going to affect maybe the rhythm of your team?
Yes, it's going to affect us. But we've got something on place in terms of our preparations during that time of the international break. Yes, with LDF, I would say I'm worried, but the worry is not about probably gonna lose or whatever, you know. I'm worried in the sense that hopefully the program works well for us during the break. But I would say playing LDF is good for us as a team. Youngsters learning, growing. It's good to play a team like LDF, which is physical, because they need to adapt. Our guys have to learn and adapt playing against sides like LDF. Yeah. So we'll utilize scenarios whereby would give us an upper hand. You know, since they are young, they need to run as much as they can. Like, you know, the likes of Musona, people who can run. So,
can he? Can he?
Yes, he can. So, in order to utilize what we possess, you know, so I think it's going to be a very interesting match today when we play LDF to see how our guys will fare. So we're really looking forward to that match.
Like you're saying that maybe our players on that day, they need to be faster, they need to run. Will it be on your plans that maybe they should avoid playing contact football? They should always be on open spaces.
Yeah, that's the idea. No contact, yes, we're all aware that football is a contact sport, but we should try by all means to avoid that. So by that word of saying running, we need to see to it that we are less on the ball, we do a lot of movements, you know, a lot of combination play, and very creative midfield and up front, creating that space whereby we play the ball into spaces, then we run into those spaces and see to it that we get the goals.
And maybe it's been an issue that we've been addressing in the past. The goal that we considered, we didn't contest, it was a free header. Hey, I don't know, coach, but aren't you thinking maybe that, I don't know, but when you came here at first, the agreement was that you will play the remaining games, then you maybe you will revise the decision after the end of the season. But if possibly that you will still be with the team the next season, are you likely to reinforce your defense? Because you've been conceding goals that we've been addressing over and over and over.
I think I would like to talk about that at the end of the season. For now, I would say I'm happy with the squad that I have. I believe in them. And it's just a matter of time. We just have to be patient with them. We just have to see to it that we nurture them well. They get the understanding, we give them moral support. I think they'll be a very good team in the very, very near future.
Okay. And, Morapeli, what did the coach say to you after the game?
What he said to us was, we had a game that was tough, but what was our idea? And what he wanted, he just saw especially what he wanted, because you know, as a team, as you have plans or the strategy, where you talk things that you want to do with normally during the game. So what he said was that we should be careful of playing, because yeah, it's a big team, but we shouldn't show respect during the game. We should respect outside the game. That's why I was saying it was a tough game and hard game. We fought like he wanted.
My last question, I think, Nadim Morapeli, at your age as a youngster, playing for a big team like Kick4Life with opportunities, what are your future ambitions?
Well, in short, I may say my future ambitions is to give back. Well, as you know that Kick4Life, it's working with youth, like I'm one of the youth. So by saying I'm giving back is, I want to achieve something that can make me to come back here and say, brothers and sisters, I'm here for you again, like Kick4Life was for me. You understand?
Aren't you seeing yourself playing maybe abroad?
Well, going abroad is something I want, and I'm willing to go there. I'm willing to go there. And I'm working hard to be one of those players that we say Kick4Life has a player somewhere far, America, everywhere abroad.
My question is, since we are a developing country, we already have one of the best young players in this year. Don't you think it's about time he gets called up to the big, to a national team? Because, I mean, he's performing way better than other players at his age.
If I was a national team coach, yeah.
So you do agree with me that he needs to be there?
I would have him in the national. There's a couple of players here that Maruti's another one. Not as young, but another one that I think is ready for the national team. But yeah, I mean, for me, Lesoetsa's got everything. For someone of his age to have the physical element, good in the air, good defending one-on-one, but also good going forward. You know, can get balls into the box, got pace, confidence. I think he's got everything just at such a young age. So yeah, if I was a national team coach, he'd be in the national team, but obviously I'm not. He'll get his chances. He'll get chances to play the national team. He'll get chances, I'm sure, to play abroad. And I think it'll happen soon rather than later.
Will you?
Yeah.
Last question for me. Kick4Life FC has too many youngsters.
Too many?
Too many youngsters.
You want us to get rid of some of them?
No, not that.
Okay.
And as a team, or as a football team, What are your plans, or what are you doing to see these youngsters maybe playing in Europe?
We're looking, obviously we're a team that will always support opportunities for players. There's potential opportunities for some of these guys coming up, whether that's Europe, whether that's America. We have contacts and we're trying to help support that. Obviously we can never make promises and it will come down to other people's decisions, but it's certainly something we'll encourage and we'll support, and if opportunities come for some of these players to play abroad, we'll do what we can to help that happen.
On average, how can you rate the referee on the weekend?
Trying to get me into trouble. probably if you're judging him against with all the other referees we've had this season, probably about average, which isn't great. There were a few decisions I think it's fair to say I was surprised with. But I think refereeing in general hasn't been great this season. I can think of one or two performances by referees where we've come off afterwards and I thought, yes, the referee did well there, but hasn't happened very often. So, be honest, I think it's something that needs to be looked at and needs to be improved at the moment in this country, because there's too many games where we're seeing inconsistent refereeing and some poor decisions that does have effect on how the game goes. So I think it's one of the areas certainly that can be worked on.
And coach, can you comment on that? I don't know if I should say it in here or say we'll talk in person, but alright, I'll just say it. Have you picked anything from the referees when they playing against your team? Is there anything that you can say that you picked that is negative from the referees? Because I'm saying this because there's some sayings out here that maybe you're one of the successful coaches in the country, and some are out there to sabotage that. Well, I'm not gonna say where I got that from, but it's that thing.
No, I think all I can say is they are human. So we just give it a bit. They are human. All we need to do as a family of Kick4Life is to concentrate on the job that is there, together with the management, the coaches. We just have to see to it that we give 120% support to the players. We work hard in training so that the games like last weekend matches, we should not only score one goal, we should score as many as we can. And the good things will just follow us.
Coach, yes, on the weekend we saw a different Morapeli. He was attacking, he was defending. What did you say to him that made him have that fire?
I sat down with him. We had a good talk. Because one of the good things really that I believe in is to make every player feel at home. They should open up. I always open up to them. And you know, we had a one-on-one, man-to-man talk. And because I could see there's a lot of potential in him. So I think I was very happy with his performance. And I still believe that he can still deliver again on a consistency level for his team and for himself also, because you know, when he does well, he also has to feel good, yeah.
And on the day we saw most of your troops performing well, but basically I'll point our wins. Maestro was exceptional on the right. Rabid was still good in the left. I don't know, but can you comment on that?
Yeah, you know, like I said after the game, he is mentioning, you know, yes, we are disappointed that we did not get a maximum point. But if you look at overall performance as a team, as a unit, individually, you know, they were brilliant. You look the likes of Tsidiso, he was outstanding. You know, he was attacking, he was defending, and which that's what I want for the players to give all out, you know, that commitment and dedication, you know. So I think, like I'm saying, you know, let's just be patient, you know, let's give them support, and definitely very soon I think will be a force that will be reckoned with.
And we saw that Morapeli coming back to the starting lineup and Morapeli on the bench. Was it because during the week on the training session you realized that maybe the performance of Morapeli was higher than of Morapeli? Or was it because of the game plan?
It was because of the game plan. I remember the other day I said, you know, every match has its own merits or different attributes. So we play according to the strengths and the weaknesses of our opponents. So we believe that Nots'i Morapeli can add more on that, and he did really put a very, very good performance.
Morapeli, what I've noticed is that during your celebrations, rather than running to a corner, you always point at your bench first. Is there a reason behind that?
Well, yeah, there is a reason. The reason is, you know, running to the corner. My colleagues are not sitting at the corner, right? They're sitting on the bench there. So the moment I saw them after scoring, I feel like, okay, my family is there, so I should go there and say, okay, guys, thanks for the opportunity that I'm one of the team, one of the players that scored now. That's how is it. There's nothing more much on it.
Cheers, guys. Thanks, Dave.